For decades, the largest living lizard species on Earth, the mighty Komodo dragon, has been shrouded in mystery and folklore surrounding its unmistakable hunting excellence. Tales of these massive reptilian predators taking down prey over 10 times their size with a single venomous bite have only added to their formidable reputation. But just how venomous is the Komodo dragon's legendary bite? On one side of the argument are those who point to the biochemical properties identified in Komodo dragon saliva as clear evidence of venom. This potent cocktail contains anticoagulants to prevent clotting, vasodilators to lower blood pressure, and other substances that collectively weaken prey over time after a bite. Bolstering this venom theory are the dragon's specialized jaw glands, similar to those associated with venom production in venomous snakes and other reptiles. These glands connect to grooved teeth via ducts, suggesting a venom delivery mechanism. The effects of their saliva, which aligns with the predatory advantages provided by venom, only adds further weight to this hypothesis. However, opponents to the true venom classification argue that despite these venom-like properties, Komodo dragons lack some key anatomical features found in venomous species. There are no hollow fangs for efficient venom injection, nor powerful muscle structures for a forceful venom delivery. Skeptics point out these perceived deficiencies in the delivery system. There's also the argument that these saliva components may serve an as yet unknown biological function unrelated to immobilizing prey. These shallow grooves in their teeth, some argue, would be inefficient for actively envenomating animals. These substances may be absorbed more passively through wound sites. So where does the current scientific understanding lie? The precise classification continues to be debated. Though most agree the substances in the Komodo dragon's saliva purely contribute to weakening and ultimately killing prey. While some call it venom due to its biochemistry and predatory effects, others advocate the term venom-like proteins to account for the differences in delivery mechanism and possible alternative roles. What can't be disputed is the overall deadlines of this bite. Because in addition to the saliva's weakening properties, the Komodo dragon's mouth also harbors a multitude of septic bacteria. This predatory sepsis leads to life-threatening infection in the bite wounds, further incapacitating the prey. Whether you view it as venom, venom-like proteins, or simply an incredibly potent pathogenic concoction, this science makes one thing clear. A bite from one of these fearsome dragons is as formidable as it is fascinating.